our friend Mark is in charge of managing his company's cloud infrastructure. One day, he realizes that several new servers are up and running, but no one on the IT team seems to be aware of who did it or why they are now online. Welcome to today's episode of Once Upon an Attack, a web series by the Splunk Education team in which we learn about common cybersecurity threats and attacks. Today, we will try to help Mark figure out what happened. This story starts a few months earlier, when Mark's organization decided to move some of their operations and services to the cloud in hopes of reducing costs and maintenance of local servers. The move also came with the promise of more robust security than what their small team could deploy on their own, so everyone was on board. After some planning, within a very limited time frame, the migration seemed successful. Almost effortless. But you see, Mark was still learning about the new platform, and he unfortunately missed enabling some critical security settings that left their cloud environment open to known exploits. One of the problems with default settings is that they are not always comprehensive enough to protect a new environment. They are also well known, and once our attacker identified a vulnerable device, they used that vulnerability and their knowledge of the platform to gain access to Mark's cloud infrastructure. Now, I know we said we would help Mark figure out how this happened, and we will do that by referencing the tactics and techniques mapped in the MITRE ATT&CK Enterprise Matrix. By doing this, he can take advantage of the additional information it contains to better plan his next steps. Let's begin. The vulnerable server in this story had public-facing services that anyone could access. But because it was part of a trusted cloud environment, it also had the capability of connecting to other private resources that were not available to the general public. Like, for example, details on the configured security roles. In other words, our attacker gained their initial access by exploiting a public-facing application. In this case, through a server-side request forgery attack. A server-side request forgery, or SSRF attack, is a security vulnerability in which an adversary tricks a server into accessing resources on their behalf. This can include resources that the server was never meant to access in the first place. That's right, friends. It's not just people who can be tricked into accidentally releasing information. Servers are vulnerable too, just in a different way. It turns out that the information the attacker was able to see via their SSRF attack showed that security permissions for some user roles were left as default, while others were misconfigured. Because of this, the attacker was able to run a serverless function attached to a misconfigured role and create a new account with escalated permissions. With credential access and persistence out of the way, the cloud environment became the perfect place for our adversary to develop resources for their malicious activities. Think of all the possibilities. By being able to create new servers without paying for them, or by simply using the existing infrastructure, our adversary could host websites for credential harvesting as part of a phishing campaign, set up a command and control center for their malware, or increase their army of botnets, all from the comfort of someone else's cloud network. Of course, exploiting the infrastructure for their benefit is not the worst thing they could have done. With their elevated permissions, they could have expanded their discovery and lateral movement tactics with the ultimate goal of collecting and exfiltrating confidential data. Which brings us back to Mark, who's wishing he had learned more about the security settings of the new platform before migrating. Luckily, this adversary only wanted to use the extra servers to make some money through crypto mining. And that's what they did. While this definitely increased the organization's cloud service bill, no critical services or confidential data was compromised. This time. With better understanding of what happened and what could have happened, the team took the time to strengthen the security settings of their new cloud service. By learning more about their new tool and following the principle of least privilege, they corrected the configuration of their security roles and ensured that each role was only given the minimum level of access it needed to fulfill their tasks. They confirmed all their cloud servers had the latest patches and minimum recommended settings for a stronger security. Their plan also included correctly setting up a secure connection with their existing Splunk Enterprise Security instance. Now they can better monitor the activity from their cloud infrastructure and enable detection rules that can help them identify and respond faster to potential incidents. Now, Mark and his team learned that just because something is in the cloud, it isn't automatically secure, and they'll make sure to carefully review security recommendations and any default settings available before migrating to a new platform or environment. He is also bookmarking the MITRE ATT&CK frameworks for future reference. To learn more about how Splunk can support your efforts against these and other types of attacks, visit the links in the description. For getting started guides and product tips, please visit Splunk Lantern. We also suggest you check out the documentation, watch additional videos on the Splunk How-To channel, and register for courses from Splunk Education. Once Upon an Attack was brought to you as part of our Blue Team Academy Cybersecurity Defense Analyst program. Thanks for watching!